Hello guys, welcome again to this channel. And we've just seen today the DCI announced that they found someone who was killing the 40 people since 2022, and the bodies were fresh, you know, since 2022, but the bodies look like they are from Mount Everest, whereby they are still fresh in their flesh. So this guy that they announced to us, unfortunately, it looks like he died in 2023, according to a Facebook post attached in this, as you can see on your screen right now. This guy died in 2023. We saw they put there a laptop that was used in census. It's called Positivo BHD, BGH. Those are our laptops that were being used by the census guys. They can tell you that. And they put there some Rizila Misokoto, that one for cannabis sativa, which are very fresh and well rolled, you know, and new, you know, like someone who is in the ghetto, you just use a gazette. They don't use these Rizila things. Yeah, so this guy died in 2023, September last year. He was an army officer, I guess so. Yeah, he was a police officer. He's called Khalisia Collins. Yeah, he died. And it's very unfortunate that the government can stoop this low to lie to Kenyans. And they have done a lot of atrocities. They have killed people. We saw the people dying in parliament. We have seen people being killed in around Rongai in Githurai. We don't know where these people were taken to. Now we found bodies in the quarry, and they're telling us that there was someone who has been killing these people since 2022. It is funny and very comical for this kind of useless government to stoop too low like this. It's not the best way to say so. So can you watch a video of those people who are, their loved ones have died? Can you check how they are collapsing at City Mortuary? They are fainting. Just watch the next video and kindly remember to subscribe to this channel. Thank you guys.
So guys, so kwa nyuma kuna mtu analia, amepata mwili ya mpendwa wao. So the bodies are being removed from Mukuru Kwa Njenga, Kware. Hiyo ni mwili moja. So guys, this is body identification. Josephine's family, We are at City Mortuary. So the family of Josephine wameenda ku identify the body of their loved ones. Yeah. So they are accompanied by the officers from the DCI. So wameenda ku identify the body. So they will identify the body. Alafu shall inform you. Huku tuko City Mortuary. Na watu ni wengi zaidi. Families are very many. Wenye wamekuja ku identify miili zenye zimetoka kule Mukuru Kwa Njenga, Kware. So these are family members. So guys, the family wamemaliza ku identify the body. So this is the family. Now washamaliza ku identify the body of their loved ones. As you can see, wako na huzuni sana sana sana. Kukumbusha tena tuko hapa City Mortuary. And guys, this is the current situation. So this is the family. And this is the current situation at City Mortuary. After family were meza ku identify the bodies of their loved ones, ni vilio. It's very sad. It's very, very sad, guys. We're live from City Mortuary. This is live from City Mortuary. And it is very, very sad. It's very, very sad. Bado kuna hawa, bado they have pia wameza kuona the body of their loved ones, and it's very painful. It's very, very painful. It's very, very, very painful. So it's very, very sad. So this is the current situation here at City Mortuary. After families wameweza kuidentify bodies of their loved ones wenye wameweza kuuliwa. Kukumbushe bado bodies zinaendelea kuwa retrieved from Mukuru Kwa Njenga. Na after families zimekuja, zimeidentify their loved ones. This is the current situation. This is the current situation. It's very, very sad. From here, this is the current situation. Tunaendelea kuwazungusha huku. So that is one family. Kuna family ingine hapo hivo. Na bado DCI wako huku. So nataka niwarudisha tena the other side. I want to show you the picture ya huku City Mortuary. Families zinaendelea kukuja to identify the bodies of their loved ones. Na kuna majonzi sana. Ukiona maafisa wa DCI wako huku, ndo wanaendeleza these guide family on how they will identify the bodies of their loved ones. Once more, we are reporting from City Mortuary. We are reporting from City Mortuary. So this is a live coverage from City Mortuary. Ukiona hao ni maafisa wa DCI, wanaendelea na records zao. So familia wanakuja, wana identify the body of their loved ones. Nikukumbusha bado bodies zinaendelea kufika huku inside the City Mortuary. Tukiendelea guys, as you can see, those are members of Red Cross. Wanaendelea ku counsel the family after they have confirmed that it's their loved ones' bodies iko hapa City Mortuary, and the situation is bad. The situation is bad. It's very sad. It's very, very sad. It's very, very sad. That is one of the family member ameweza kuanguka. So guys, this is the current situation. It's very, very sad. After watu wameza ku identify body kama hii familia, their loved one aliweza kupatikana huko Mukuru Kwa Njenga, wamekuja wameconfirm ni yeye, wameletwa na maafisa wa DCI, and it's very, very sad. It's very, very sad. So members of the Red Cross ndo wako pale hivi, at least to give them just to accompany, give them motivation, to encourage, because it's not easy. And this is a live coverage from City Mortuary, where families wanaendelea to identify the bodies of their loved ones.